Welcome back, and thanks for tuning in to episode 33 of LabPadre's SpaceX and Starbase weekly updates. We're getting closer to launch day, so let's dig in. Starting off this week in Florida, in the early hours of Saturday morning, Falcon 9 booster B1069 launched from Space Launch Complex 40 carrying the Hotbird 13F telecommunications satellite on its way to geostationary orbit. The next morning, SpaceX support ship Bob towed a short fall of gravitas out to Port Canaveral in preparation for Thursday's Starlink 4-36 mission. That afternoon at Starbase, Ship 24 was lifted free from Booster 7 once again. Unlike last week, however, the ship was not immediately reseated, but rather the chopsticks lowered it back onto its waiting transport stand. Late Monday morning, Booster 10's six-ring partial methane tank was stacked onto the next three-ring section in Mega Bay. That afternoon, at Historical Launch Complex 39A, one of the cryogenic storage tanks that was installed between the new vertical tank and the Starship launch tower was removed from its mount for unknown reasons. A short time later, that same tank was seen being driven away from the pad before ending up in the parking lot next to the dock at the Vehicle Assembly Building's turn basin. Early Tuesday morning, Dragon recovery vessel Shannon returned to Port Canaveral after being stationed in the Gulf of Mexico for possible recovery operations for Crew 4's return to Earth last week. Early on Wednesday, back at Starbase, the ship quick disconnect mechanism on the launch tower arm underwent additional testing as it was extended and retracted multiple times. This testing continued over a roughly two-hour period before SpaceX was apparently satisfied with the results and the quick disconnect was left in the retracted position. Moving back to Historical Launch Complex 39A once again, shortly before noon Wednesday, the transporter erector, which had recently been reconfigured in preparation for the upcoming Falcon Heavy launch, was raised to the vertical position on the Falcon launch pad. Later that afternoon, the transporter erector was leaned back, likely in a launch simulation, before lowering the rest of the way to the ground. Soon we should see it roll down the ramp to SpaceX's horizontal assembly facility to pick up the Falcon Heavy for the USSF 44 mission, expected to launch at the end of this month. A few hours later, Doug returned to Port Canaveral, towing Just Read the Instructions with Falcon 9 booster B1069 from the Hotbird 13F launch earlier in the week. Wednesday evening, a new Starship was rolled out of High Bay for the first time since Ship 24 made its first trip to the launch pad almost 5 months ago. Ship 25 was moved down to Highway 4 to the launch site to begin its testing campaign. For the first time ever, two Starships and two Super Heavy boosters are stationed at the launch complex. Shortly after the ship arrived at the launch site, crews went up in lifts to connect it to SpaceX's LR11000 crane next to suborbital test stand A. A few hours later, the seemingly never-ending saga of the cryogenic pumps continued as a crane picked up a new pump and installed it in the third methane pump slot. A short time later, the pump's motor was lifted and installed as well. Around the same time, the ship quick disconnect arm on the launch tower was swung out, indicating that Ship 24 would soon return to its perch on the top of Booster 7. Thursday morning, crews got to work and Ship 25 was lifted off its transport stand and placed onto the test stand A, where it will soon undergo testing. Likely, this will start with ambient pressure testing before moving on to cryogenic proofing. This stand also has the ship thrust rams, so puck shucking is also possible. While Ship 25 was in the air, Ship 24 decided to join in the fun as the chopsticks lifted it free of the transport stand. Over the next hour, the ship was once again lifted and translated over above the booster. Next, the QD arm was rotated back to the stack and the ship was slowly lowered down towards the Super Heavy. Then the chopsticks made small adjustments to align it properly with the top of the booster below. As contact was made, both vehicles shifted slightly before the ship was lowered the last bit, completing the full stack. As Ship 24 was being lifted, one of SpaceX's drones flew by Rover 2 on its way to observe the stacking operations at the orbital launch pad. While two Starships were being lifted at Starbase, Falcon 9 booster B1069 was also lifted into the air at Port Canaveral as it was moved from the drone ship to the dock. As the booster was being set down on the dock, in the background, B-1062 was launched from Space Launch Complex 40 for the Starlink 4-36 mission, sending another 54 Starlinks into low Earth orbit. Back in Texas, the tower ship quick disconnect was extended toward ship 24. Once close to the ship, it is adjusted and aligned with the ports on the ship before making the final attachment. Later, the quick disconnect was retracted and a likely full-speed test of the system shown here in real time. Shortly after this apparent launch speed test, the quick disconnect was again extended towards the ship before aligning and connecting to the vehicle one more time. Meanwhile, down Highway 4 at the build site, Ship 27's payload bay section was moved out of Tent 3 and into the ring yard. A short time later, Ship 27's nose cone was moved from the windbreak down Highway 4 and joined the payload section in the ring yard. Next, Ship 26's recently stacked common dome and mid-lock's 8-ring section was rolled out of high bay and moved over into mid bay. High bay did not stay empty for long, as Ship 26's combined nose cone and payload sections were moved into the building from mid bay about an hour later. And finally for this week, with Ship 25 secured to test stand A, crews took lifts up and unhooked it from the crane. And there you have it, another SpaceX and Starbase weekly update brought to you by LabPadre. We'll see you next week, and thanks for watching. LabPadre out.